Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is. Hello, everyone. This is Badge Wild. And today I am sailing on the ocean. I would like to apologize to all of y'all about my Monday hiatus, but I ended up getting sick. There's nothing I could really do about it. And also, I live with a nurse, so I mean, her prescription was you need to stay down in bed, not do anything stupid. Rest, relaxation, lots of liquids. Oh, so many liquids. I'm so sick and tired of taking a piss. Anywho, today, I'd like to explain something that's happened. So apparently a lot happened when I was gone this weekend with my hiatus. I usually try to play every single day so I can keep up with what's happening. But during my hiatus, during me being sick, apparently the base got raided. And when I got here today, I was there just in time. I got a new Dodo security system, by the way, because the old one died. Fido stayed alone just long enough to tell me who raided the base. And when I went to go confront them about it, or at least scout them out, they were already destroyed. And it looked like a couple other bases were hit at the same time. So I'm having to consider my options at the moment. I need a specialized plant. A legend has told me of a special plant called Plant Species X. And I've already got this plant for some people already. And it is one of those... Let me just show you guys real quick. In the middle of the map, you'll see this big island, or this river section in the middle of the map is this little area around 50 longitude and 50 latitude. Within that area, out a couple of latitude points outward, is basically a swamp. And the swamp is super dangerous. It has giant boa constrictors called Titan boas. It's got giant crocodiles, which we've seen those before. It has a set of alligators, which I really hate those things, which also poison you. And giant battle toads. There's a Quetz up above me. Cool. It also has leeches, bugs, raptors, carnos, compies, anything that wants to, like, kill you and eat you is in the swamp. But I found an area of Plant Species X a while back in one of my earlier plays around 50 longitude and 80 latitude. It's like right smack there. And so that's where we're going. It's a little peninsula looking thing coming off. And my plan is to sail over there, get some Plant Species X. I've already got some already. I got 6 seeds, but I want more because I want my base to be thoroughly defended, because we are fixing to start building up the base. My production capability. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the swamp. See a Sarco right over there. And this is the area we're going to try and get into to get our Plant Species X. You see, it looks like there's an alligator right behind the Sarco. And there's a Sarco just laying down on the beach. That's that big thing right there. He's the bigger alligator, the Sarco is. Not as fast. The other alligator, though, I can't pronounce his name, but it is wickedly fast. It jumps ungodly far and can poison you. And we also have these giant snakes in here called Titan boas. Humongous jokers now. And what they do is they can bite you and toper you. There are frogs in here. I don't know what that is in the water right there. Odd looking. There's also a... that's a log. I think it's a log. Now, you know the Titan boa is big when I'm sitting here mistaking a log for a Titan boa. There's one of the alligators right there in the water. You see him moving around in circles right there. And that joker can run you down. Whoa. Where was that at? I don't want to get too close to him. What we're going to do is we're going to head up the beach a little bit, because what we want is on the other side of the island. So long as I don't run into some idiot like I did last time. But this time I got prepared. I brought the pistol because of all the dangerous monsters and dinosaurs that are in here, but I got thinking about it afterward. It wasn't a good idea because I ended up losing it after I put a few rounds in some dude's bird. So this time we're bringing the bow and arrow. Me a little primitive. This way, if I lose something this time around, I don't. Something really big hasn't been lost. Okay. Here we go. So what you want to do is you want to head in from this side of the island. Now, there's a problem with this. I call this little area Carno Gauntlet. Number one, you see the big guy back there. That's a big something. I'm betting that's almost an allosaur. Hopefully it's just an orthoraptor from the way it looks. In the jungle, in the swamp over here, we have sarcos, alligators, and titan boas, and leeches, and bugs. Over here in the forest, we have bugs, carnos, T-Rexes, and allosaurs. So, I mean, this is a problem going in, and I think that's a carnosaur in my way right there. I don't know how to get past it. Whoop. And apparently, I got a dillo on me, so we're going to try and avoid him. And looks like there's a quetz in there or something. I don't want to run too much because it'll eat my stamina up. And if you run a lot, your stamina is going to just bottom out before you have any option. No, that's not a quetz. I don't know what that thing is, but it's a big flyer. I'd like to have one. Right, I need to watch these forests here because anything that makes a big shadow is going to be a big problem. I'll throw the bow away for a moment. Quick note, if you see parasaurs around, that usually means there isn't something really dangerous near. Well, something picked a fight with that. What is that? Please tell me they're bugs. Oh, that's a titan boa. Right there, see it? Ain't she beautiful? I'm running up here getting it. I'm running over here like the crocodile hunter. See how beautiful this thing is? See, this turtle just killed it. When you look at the size of this snake right here, it's massive. I'm gonna try and get some hide off this thing real quick because I'm not gonna get another chance. Oh wait, no, I can't drag, I can't access its inventory. It doesn't have any inventory. Oh well. Well, I'll get a whole crap load of hide off this bad boy.
Oh wow, look at that. 33 hide and 27 meat, folks. You know, that is a big joker if it gives off a bunch of hide meat. I gotta watch out for stingrays.
Alright. Where's Mr. Allosaur? I saw him over here a minute ago. Ah, and it's foggy now, too. This creates all kinds of problems when it gets foggy. So, yeah. Okay. Like I said before, I want to watch my stamina because if I use my stamina too much, two bad things will happen if I use my stamina too much, which will be I'll not have the ability to run. Ooh. Especially for things like that. I won't have the ability to run fast. And being able to sprint real quickly is great. Secondly, snap. That was a Velociraptor. No, that was a Utah Raptor, actually. Velociraptors be like compies, almost. I'm gonna run past these guys. Ah, really? I'm gonna fall off a cliff. Can't see. Got 3 seconds left of this nonsense, and I can't see. I'm gonna run right into an Allosaur, I bet. See if I can get him to kite something else. Okay. I looked over. Apparently the Allosaur left. I don't know where he went. I'm freaking out just a little bit about that. You see my stamina gauge slowly is going up. If I just stop right here, which I think I can. You see my hunger gauge deplete just a little bit. And that's nifty because it's kind of pulling off the fact of you're using a lot of your stamina. So you're going to end up using up your hunger, whatever food or carbs, I guess, are in your system. My hydration didn't go down because apparently I am drinking water as I walk, which is fun. Okay. Let's see if we can sneak past all the dangerous stuff that is inside this swamp. And I'm telling you, there's a bunch of dangerous stuff inside this swamp. And this fog is hampering my vision. One of the cool things about this location, though, is if you die, I don't want to die because I would like to not die. But one of the things about this location is it is an area where you can simply respawn. You basically respawn right back at the beach where the boat is at. So if you stop there, you're all right. Looks like the fog is lifting a bit, and I'm getting hot from the humidity. Joy. And the rain has stopped, so now I got to really worry about dehydration. Another thing also, when you're walking around like this, you need to pick up everything. Hit a bush. You see, I'm getting me some goodies on the way. And you, sir, I could so use that. So all I've got to really do right now is walk, don't run. And I can conserve a lot of stamina and energy. I'm just hoping that I can get to this without triggering a Titan Bower or something else. I don't know what that was. What was that? Gonna have to get serious now. Problem the swamp is, man, when you enter into it, you don't know what you're getting into until you're already inside. Just gotta sneak around these critters here and find this stinking plant. I don't know where it is. I got something moving back there. I think that's a Phalomius. I can't see the plant I'm after. Got something just kited up on another animal. Very hard to do this because as I go in here, I'm going to run into some mosquitoes. Because normally they're not that big of a problem, but... Hang on, let me run back here real quick before we just go charging in here. Like I did. I don't know what that stupid noise is. I don't know what's shooting at me. Okay, what am I going to do? I'm going to increase the gamma correctness because then I'll be able to see better. Okay, now we can see better. I'll be a little blind when I walk out, but y'all get a better look at this plant once I find it. Okay, where? Plant species X, plant species X. Trying to listen for bugs, too, because once they come near me, I should be able to hear them. There it is. What was that? Alright, here's our target. Get as much of these as I can. I didn't get a lot last time. Oh, wow, there's two of them.
Awesome.
Any more? Nope. Alright, now we got to exfil. So yeah, folks, that's where this is. It's like right next to the swamp area. So you can easily get in here without triggering any of the bigger animals if you're just cautious. Like, right out here is where the swamp ends. So you probably won't have to worry about any big animals other than, like I said, carnos or allosauruses. And yeah, you saw the titan boa we saw, and you saw the sarco and the alligator. And then there are leeches in there that are just problems all around. So as of right now, I'm going to walk out. I know I was moving pretty hot and heavy right there, but I'm going to walk out, conserve my stamina, because... something attacks me, I'll have all the stamina I need to escape it. This also works with players too, because if another player comes after you, they may try to sprint on you. And my opinion is, if you're going to kill someone, just get to guns and then just shoot them from a distance. It'll save you time and energy. But if you... Oh, look, there's a frog over there. Yeah, here's another character that... Here's another thing here. It's a little frog. I'll move up here so you can take a look at him. Yeah, these guys, you can ride them. Imagine this. Riding a battle toad into battle. They can actually toper and knock things out with their tongue. They lick them. They lick them asleep. God, that sounded dirty. Anyway, I'm going to titan bow up there. As I was saying, sometimes another player will run up on you, and they'll basically run their... stamina to about half. Well, if they've got half and you've got a full tank of gas and they've got a half a tank of gas, usually all you got to do is just outrun them. long enough to... Ooh, frick. Like I said, you gotta outrun them. That thing there, I cannot outrun. Dang, a gator just has to be right there. What's he doing? We'll sneak around him. I've got too much precious cargo right now. I need these seeds. We'll give him a wide berth. Because once that Joker locks onto you, I don't know what speed you have to be to outrun him. You see him right up here. The one behind him is a Sarco. That thing there on four legs, with its back legs up. Oh, good. He's aggroing another animal, so that's all right. They are getting close to me, though. God, where's my raft? I'm lagging. They are getting close. Oh, I can't outrun that thing in the water. This is bad. I bet he is going right near my... Yep. That dang parasaur. Okay. I may have a chance here. Now get to the raft and get out of here. Alright, we're in the water. Yeah, that's how you get the plant species X. Hopefully, when I get back to base, we'll have some. Look at this dude, man. He's just tearing that parasaur up. There's a Sarco. Like I said, they got some mean stuff out there. Once a Sarco gets you, Sarco probably got some stuff in his stomach. You should probably kill him and get some stuff out. Anyway, hopefully when I'm done, I'll be back at base with all my plant species X. And we'll have a crap load more turrets. Because I may have to tame something in order to feed these turrets, but... Eh, well. That's Ark life. Okay, so I got the farm plots. That's what we're going to do. I got a nice place I can set them right here. So I'm going to set this one up right by the door. And what we're going to do here is I'm going to set two fertilizer and plant species X. And see right here, just a little bit of water gets these guys going, and there's enough water in just raining that will protect everything. And so what we're going to do also is somewhere on here. I guess I'll have to wait till the thing grows to maturity. But what we're going to do over here is we're going to set another one. Right about there. And we are going to throw one plant species X. And we're going to throw two fertilizer in there. Now, what's going to happen is this is going to build up some water, and these large farm plots are going to start growing plant species X. When they completely get up there, I'm going to have these mean turrets sitting outside my base. And they will shoot... Let me see here. If I go over to plant species X, and you'll see it says, plant this in a viable large crop plot to grow a frightening-looking defensive plant, which will shoot poisonous spores at any interlopers. In other words, it will shoot them with very dangerous stuff. So, the next thing I'm going to do to this base is I also want to put a cooking pot in, because I'm not quite done upgrading. Maybe you hadn't guessed. And I want to put one of these up there, if I can. We'll go up there. This might be better outside. Let me just put this outside for a minute. There we go. Yeah, that's better. We'll set this bad boy outside. I always wanted a barbecue pit outside. That's what we're going to do. We're going to put a nice little barbecue thing outside. I can use this to make kibble and stuff like that. But, yeah, I'm hoping I can get over here in a minute. And what I'm going to attempt to do is extend the base out just a tad over here outward and around so we can get us a dino pen started. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to build this area out as best I can. I'm going to put a trike here, maybe an RG in this general vicinity, maybe up top. I may just make an RG pen up top That'd be a cool idea. I could do an RG pin up top, have a rope ladder going up to the RG pin, and then just come out the very top section of the base. And then I could put some plant turrets on top, around the edges, and all on the inside. I've got like 20-something of these things. So all I need right now is a Philomia, guys, and a trike. That's going to probably be the next mission tomorrow, or the next mission on Friday. We're going to head out, and we're going to get us a trike, we're going to get us a Philomia, and we're going to tame these jokers. I need the Philomia for something specific. I need a... They're slow and kind of like pigs, but he'll be happy because he likes stem berries. If I give him a bunch of stem berries, he'll poop. Yeah, he will poop and poop a lot. So, yep, it's Badger Wild, folks. Kicking it up in Ark. Sorry about my hiatus. I'm glad I'm back with you guys and I'm not sick anymore. And as always, just another day and another dime. I'll see y'all next time.